NixOS just dropped its latest release with 25.05 Warbler, and it's packed with big improvements, new tools, and even a few experimental surprises. So let's start off with the Cosmic Desktop, because it's now available on NixOS. NixOS now has initial support for the Cosmic Desktop environment, which is currently at Alpha 7. So Cosmic is System76's new Rust-based desktop environment. It is not ready to go just yet. It's still in the development stage, in the alpha stage, but getting it into NixOS, even in experimental form, is pretty cool and adds to the early cross-distro adoption for the desktop itself, adding to the growing list of distros that have it, such as Fedora. So speaking of Cosmic, if you'd like to know what I think of Cosmic, I made a couple of videos showing a full walkthrough of my experience with the Cosmic Desktop, which I'll have linked in the show notes. I made a video on the very first version of the first alpha release, and then again on Alpha 7. Plus, this is so cool because System76 are quite responsive, because I've received news that they have watched my coverage of their desktop and have already fixed some things that I pointed out in the latest video and are working on some others. So that's pretty awesome. Now let's get back to NixOS, because one of NixOS's core tools just got a total rewrite. NixOS Rebuild NG is a full rewrite of NixOS Rebuild in Python, and it's available for testing. It's a major modernization effort that could streamline system rebuilds and improve future flexibility, especially with Python's easier extensibility. There's also a new way to build custom NixOS images. A NixOS Rebuild Build Image subcommand has been added. It allows users to build platform-specific images from their NixOS configurations. This brings official image building tools in line with what the community has done with the NixOS generators, and it's now baked directly into the distro. And speaking of tools, NixOS Option has also been overhauled. NixOS-Option has been rewritten to a Nix expression called by a simple bash script. It's behind-the-scenes change, but it takes a lower maintenance thing for this to happen, so it adds supports for flakes, which matters for users trying to build more complex configurations. There's also big news for graphics performance and packaging flexibility. The packaging of Mesa graphic drivers have been significantly reworked, and this should reduce headaches when dealing with mismatched Mesa versions and simplify how users control which graphic stacks they're using. SSH security just got a meaningful bump as well, because OpenSSH has been updated from 9.9p2 to 10.0p2, dropping support for DSA keys and adding new SSH auth binary. These updates help harden systems against modern threats while improving performance under memory pressure. Small change, but big impact. They've also done some updates for other desktop environments, such as GNOME is now GNOME 48, KDE Plasma is now 6.3, and others such as XFCE and more.